first thing that I'm going to say before I get into the specifics and details of what I endured and what I witnessed others endure firsthand in the slave labor cult, run by power-hungry individuals living lavish lifestyles on the dime of rich parents who dump their kids here thinking that it's a good place that's going to help them. And this is after they're adults, too, which makes the whole thing weird. Yes, this community is breaking all sorts of laws, committing all sorts of crime. Most important thing I would say, you need to know if you're an individual considering entering this community, or if you are a family member or a friend of somebody that you are trying to get into this community, be it for drug addiction, alcoholism, mental illness, eating disorders. This important thing for you to know is, A, there are no licensed professionals awaiting your loved one or you if you're the one looking into this community when you get there. There are not medical professionals, they're not psychological professionals, they're not counselors, there's no sort of nutritionist, any type of technician, anybody professional that is needed to treat something like a drug addiction. No medical detox going on in these places. What I can tell you they're going to do is when your loved one or yourself is in full-fledged withdrawal, they're going to hand you a wheelbarrow and an axe and have you chop wood for 12 hours, which they're going to use to make into things with other people that are being labored there for free, who sell in these shops to make money for themselves. It's not for you. It's not for the individuals who enter the community for help. This community has become one of the greatest scams. There are a lot of smaller versions of this type of thing that breaks out. People without medical licenses have no business claiming that they are this or that they can do this. And they're taking advantage of vulnerable individuals that are generally in a very desperate, dangerous situation. Take advantage of their loved ones who are scared to death for them and want to get them actual help. The individuals in this community do not stay clean because they're recovering. They don't stay off drugs and alcohol because they're being rehabilitated. They're off drugs and alcohol because they have no other option. They are being held there against their will. They are trapped, and this is not just for a detoxification period. This is for years. Right now, in this very moment, there are countless individuals trying to escape right now, planning escapes right now, who've already failed at escaping. I understand that seeing your loved one clean once a year, like they're not on drugs anymore and they're smiling and they look super happy, and all these other people that are smiling, acting super happy. Understand it is an act. This is a Wizard of Oz situation. There is one annual retreat in which families from all over the world can visit their loved one in the community and see them once a year in a very controlled setting on the Hill of Saluzzo, where the mother house is, where they also lock all our documents and passports and things away, no matter where we're at, no matter what country we're in. We take everything that identifies who we are. Understand, when I escaped on foot the second time, that was successful. I didn't have my ID. I didn't have my passport. I was there totally illegally and I didn't know it. And I was being held against my will. I had nothing to prove who I was. I had no way to prove I was an American citizen. I had no way to prove I was who I said I was. You add that together with the language that everybody conforms to and the fact that we're not allowed to speak our mother tongues at all when we're there. When I stopped speaking English because I wasn't allowed to unless I was translating for them, which was another type of slave labor that they would do. They used me for translation, all sorts of data entry translation on their websites, at the conferences, at these places. All the different types of work. They look for all sorts of talent, all types of work, anything that they can sucker out of whatever individual comes in there. And the most important thing to them is always going to be, and the first people that are going to get their loved ones in are the parents or family members that have more money to invest. Okay, because Albino, Joyce, all these other people in charge of these houses that are running this place, but specifically the one in America, the traffickers, the human traffickers in Florida, they're not interested in helping with that money. Your loved one will be given the bare minimum and below bare minimum to survive and be healthy. They will be neglected. They will be bullied. They will be humiliated. They will be abused. They will be controlled. They will be held against their will. They will be forced to conform to ideas they do not believe in or agree with. They will work ridiculous hours, hard labor, not get enough sleep, not get enough food, do nothing but slave labor, and then be forced to do these repetitious prayers and things that they do in the community because it's a Catholic community, despite the fact that, as I was saying in my previous upload, it's completely anti-Catholic doctrine spoken as if it's Catholic in there. What I care about is people being held against their will there. What I care about is people struggling with an addiction or a mental illness or otherwise seeking help. Their loved ones who want them to get help are being taken advantage of by these people. It's power and money they crave, and that is what they have manipulated this entire system. I believe it started with a good intention, just a little old Italian nun with the best intentions at heart. That's my opinion of her, all right? But that's not what it is anymore, and it's not what it was by the time I got there. You will be forced into a singular conformed mind. If you resist, you will be abused. Laws will be broken. You will be held against your will. The amount of gaslighting and psychological manipulation tactics that go on a daily basis to break down the individuals in this community, break everything down that they believe, break their entire identity down to they don't even remember where they're from, can't remember the sound of their own family's voices. They play those cassette tapes, and they're specifically designated, ordained within Comunitá. Priests show up and send the same subliminal messages in their homilies. If you conform to their singular mind and you do as they say without question and you do not resist, you will rise within the community, authority rank power wise. That's where you end up somebody like Irena. Irena had already been there, I think somewhere around 8 or 9 years by the time I showed up in Soliano. She met her husband in this community. They got married in this community. I mentioned this in previous uploads. They will marry people in this community. It's their own little world. They have their own priests, their own nuns, even before they were officially permitted. They'll marry individuals, and it will be because you are complying and doing as they say. They will control and prevent relationships from people that are not conforming to this one singular mindset. Cannot be controlled. Not only are there no professionals regarding the mental health. That includes the medical detox, anything like that. That's all made up. Anything they tell you about being equipped for that, they're not. Detox is horrific. Expecting anybody to do anything when they're going through it is cruel. Not only that you wouldn't be helping the person medically detox, but that you would be forcing them to chop wood for 12 hours in the middle of winter when they're in the peak of their detox. It's sadistic. Big part of what breaks the person down initially. So is there a positive in the sense that for loved ones, you're seeing that they're clean and they're not on drugs because they're in this community? Of course, it's a positive that somebody's not on a drug, okay? But the reason for why does matter. When the community actually brainwashes us into believing that the world outside is a matrix and the Comunitá Cenacolo is the real world. Everybody on the outside just doesn't know. Okay, we're just these superior illuminated beings. Most who leave the community will relapse. Most will. But it's not because they left the community. Most of those who leave the community, like myself and others who escaped that relapsed and then got actual treatment later down the road, or maybe some didn't make it. But the bottom line is, we're clean in the community because we're being held against our will and have no other option. That's not treating an addiction. That's attaining a detox via a very cruel means that has not been proven to be effective. We're only off drugs in there because there are no drugs in there. How long are you going to hold somebody prisoner? Is it okay that you hold them there for the rest of their lives then just because it's keeping drugs out of their system? To get actual treatment for a diagnosable disease and illnesses that can be treated by actual professionals. I'm not just talking light cases of mental illness. Many of us, when I was in there, are dying of eating disorder and are being abused and bullied. Their illnesses, vulnerabilities are being used against them. Like when Irene in the house of Civiliano, because I wouldn't stop asking questions to Nevis, the heretic nun there, started taking food away from me. When I was in recovery, just months into recovery from anorexia nervosa that nearly killed me. When you're told there are professionals or those equipped to deal with your loved one or your mental illness, drug addiction, yes, they achieve the person being clean while they're being held prisoner there. That's it. And that's why most will relapse when they come out, because they haven't actually been treated. They haven't actually been rehabilitated. So you're removing something physically from their body that they have no say in, and you're not rehabilitating, not getting treatment for how it happened and why it happened and preventing it happening in the real world, the actual world out there. Whether we like it or not, this is the world we have. We're all on this earth here. What we've got, it is the real world. And the real world, unfortunately, includes power-hungry, money-loving individuals who would take advantage of such vulnerable people for their own monetary gain.